Hey guys, what's up? Jack of all trades here with more Legend of Zelda: The Minish Cap. We're at a milestone in this Let's Play. I'm at my 20th episode. You know, this is something really cool for me. I'm really making progress now. I'm actually getting back into it, and it's really making me remember why I love it so much. So, let's get up here. Something's wrong. We are the Tribe of the Winds. Long have we lived with the winds, we have mastered them, now we join them. Together with the great winds at our backs, we head for the skies. Those who come seeking our power must play the notes Zephyr teaches. Zephyr? What the heck is Zephyr? May they lead you onward to the power that you seek. Wait a second. So you're telling me, after all that, I didn't get the wind element? No, I got the Ocarina of Wind, north, south, east, west. Are all just a breath away. Wait a second. I do believe this is where the Tribe of Winds once lived, so they left the heavens and taken their element with them. Wait a second. So you're telling me I went through that temple. I went through that temple. And I didn't have to. Actually, no, you kind of did. And it does that cool little thing, and you got and remember all those windstone things we got before? Yep, this is where they come in handy now. Travel to this wind crest. Yes. This is the Ocarina of Wind is basically our teleporting thingy. Now of course there are some things now that we do have the Ocarina of Wind, it's pretty cool. Now, let's see if we can go do more stuff in Hyrule. Of course, we didn't yet. No, we didn't get the... No! Bad crow bird thing that's apparently strong enough to pick up Link. I gotta get that off of there. Let's get my mole mitts back up, because I love those things. Look at Link! Look at him! Rawr! Rawr! He's so manly! Oh, God. Yeah, sometimes you can dig up those things. They're not that big of a hassle, but, Yeah. Oh, these four trees, by the way, they do pose some importance later on, but that's with a certain side quest that I'm not the biggest fan of, so yeah. Let's see if these guards won't let us through this way. No, they will not. As of right now, we still only have over here, and I believe there is a rope over here, a golden one. I know there's a ladder down here which leads to Swift Blade or Gray Blade, whatever the heck you want to call them, or Morning Blade. I don't know anymore. So let's go down here. We can't do anything in here yet, but there's something I want to pick up while I'm here. You got a piece of heart. Now we only need two more to collect our energy, and we're already at 8. Like I said before, guys, I'm not going to be 100%ing this game anymore, sadly, guys, because I already messed up, and I don't feel like playing through all this again. So sorry, guys. If you want to see 100% Let's Play, this isn't the Let's Play for you. I hope you guys, the ones that still watch this, will watch it, you know, because of... You know, there is still some cool stuff I do want to do. I do want to try, make this Let's Play as fun and entertaining as I still possibly can. Now, I did talk about the mole mitts a little bit. Now, I'm going to show you applications they have outside of that temple. Now, there should be one somewhere here in Hyrule Castle Town, so let's go down here. Yes. Oh, there it is. So basically, this is a cool little mini area we can go into with the mole mitts. And now we're under... We're under Hyrule Castle Town, and it gives us this nifty little music theme. Got a kinstone piece. Yeah, basically, this is... You usually will find some, like, rupees down here. And the... Whoa. It's best to get rid of these when you're in an open area so they won't pester you anymore. Because if you get rid of them in a closed area, that can happen, and they become a nuisance. Basically, we got a ladder. Oh, what? Crap. Now we do have a nifty little puzzle we can do down here. Basically, I just messed up that puzzle, so we gotta come back in and... or go back out and come back in so we can reset it, or not. Yeah, so I messed up with the puzzle a little bit. Oh well. Basically, let's just leave here now, using our newfound mole mittens. If we move fast enough, basically they can't really, you know, stay on us for that long, and that's kind of our goal when it comes to these things, because we don't want them on us at all. So it's dig, 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 and of course, finally, dig. And now we cut our way back out. Now, there is some stuff I do want to get now. It actually involves going back to Borkin's shop. Something I do believe I picked up in an earlier episode, but I never got to pick up, so I'm going to re-pick it up again. So, hey, Borkin, what's up? 80 rupees for a wallet that held the king's ransom. Now, I'm not going to have to worry about getting, I'm not going to have to worry about running out of room for the rupees I pick up. I'm not going to be more hesitant around chests. Which is actually good, because I'm going to need it, because watch what happens when we come out and come back in. There's a new item for sale, the boomerang. We're going to need that. We're not going to need that, but for, you know, because I kind of want to get it, we're going to get it, okay? Now, the next area, of course, is... the next element is near Lake Kilia. Now, how are we going to get there? I wonder who'd be able to help us out with something like that. So, well, for starters, let's go and, you know, let's... now, see, Ezlo's only half right there. We don't have to stand on a wind crest for him to tell us where to go, but it really helps. But no, we have to go to Lake Hylia now. Hylia, Hylia, yes. Travel to this wind crest. Basically... now we're gonna go in here and bada boom. Basically, we're kind of just see. There's the next palace temple right there, but you can't get to it right now. So let's ooh. You want to fuse kinstones? Let's give it a try. Please tell me I have the kinstone. No. Yeah. Basically, when they have a heart over their head, that means basically that. Yeah. You want to enter the Temple of Droplets? The Temple of Droplets. Cool name. I have heard of rumors that one Minish actually did find a way in long ago. That Minish is the Elder Librari. He's found in semi-retirement in that town library. The library should be opening soon. Perhaps you can go find him. Basically, you have to talk to that Minish. If you try and do anything ahead of time, if you want to talk to him ahead of time, you can't do it. The library stays closed until you talk to that guy right there. Which is, I believe, one of the most broken physics in the game, or one of the most broken things in the game, but it really kind of prevents you from sequence breaking, and you need to talk to this guy because he gives you access to two of the most useful items in this game that really, once you get these two items, there is no, you know, there is no stopping. There are masks on these walls. And, naturally, with masks, you know, the only fun thing to do is this. Break them for rupees. Run! Fall. They will all, if I'm correct, they will always give you Christmas colors. Hi.
Wonder what I should check out today.
Well, I'll tell you what you should do. You should fuse kinstones with me, hopefully. Yes! Claus. His name is Claus? Like Santa? Santa! No, yeah. He's gonna make a rope or some golden monster, I think. Or chest. Yeah, chest. So that should be a lot of rupees for us if I so choose to go back and get that. But I probably won't, mainly because... oh, whoa. Sometimes these books move on their own. I've seen it. And don't tell me I'm crazy. I ain't crazy. He looks kind of familiar. You want to fuse kinstones? Sure, why not? Oh, cool. Sturgeon. He kind of his sprite looks like the Orca guy's brother from, Legend of Zelda, the Wind Waker. Then again, this game is kind of, I guess you could call it a continuation of Wind Waker if you so chose to, but I wouldn't because it's not in the slightest. Oh, cool, it's in Hyrule Town. It fit perfectly. I didn't expect that. Maybe something good will happen now. Basically, on the roof here, you've probably seen it around somewhere, is this. So you jump on here, we shrink-a-dink down, go into the little hole right here. Oh, and there are tracks right here. Oh, well, this could be a good sign. Oh, wow, there's a little indent right here. Hi, buddy, what's up? Hey, this is no good at all. Human borrowed a book, and now none of us can get back to the Elder. Yeah, basically, if you try and go up there, guess what? You can't. Actually, you can talk to this guy right here. I think he wants to fuse, or not. We can't get up the shelf because a human checked that book out. But at least we don't have to listen to elder librarians boring old sorts. Hey, whoa. Old people have a lot to teach us. Now, of course, this guy said, talk to the librarian. So we can't naturally do that as a Minish. What we have to do is, of course, same monotonous thing we always do. Try to take over the world. No, I mean, go up here. Bada bing, bada boom. Hit that right there. And that little staircase thing is, this guy's not the librarian. If I'm correct, we have to go downstairs, of course, because it'd be too easy to talk to a librarian upstairs. Go down here. I believe it's one of these two people. I'm not sure which one. Welcome to the library. Say, aren't you Smith's grandson, Link? The book's missing from the bookshelf on the second floor? Yes, they've been checked out for quite a while. They're very overdue, so that dude owes some fines. Take a Hawaiian bestiary, for example. Been gone for ages. Checked out by a girl with a cat. She said she had a new cat at her house. Wanted to learn more about it. She did. Okay, so basically, they give us hints on where to find these books. We have to find a girl who has a cat at her house. There aren't many girls with cats at their houses, though. So, I mean, you gotta think. If I'm correct, it would be this house right here is the house you want to go into. Hey, look at that, Link. There's a book on top of the bookcase. How are you going to get it? Yeah, basically, dude's saying, we can't do this. We can't take the old Link to the Past route and just knock it down. No. What we have to do is this. Go next door. Flip the pot. Hopefully the dog won't attack us. It won't. Oh, it wants to fuse kinstones. Cool. You want to fuse kinstones? Yeah, sure. I can't. Oh, wait. No, I can't. Actually, yes, I can. Sweet. What does it want to fuse for? A pot. So it's going to give us a chest somewhere in the world. We go down here, fuse kinstones with Rolf, which is an odd name for a dog. I've never heard of a dog named Rolf, but I digress. So we fuse kinstones with Rolf, and we get a new chest here in the forest. Now, naturally, the things you would want to fuse for
that's right, I forgot one important thing. If I'm correct, we can't go anywhere until that fire's put out. I don't think we can just poof, make it go away. No, we have to get an empty bottle. Can you guess where this is going? We have to do something incredibly mean. Hopefully we can do it in this really shallow water here. No, we cannot. Find somewhere a little bit more plentiful when it comes to the water. Now, Link, you know you can't swim. Alright, you put water in your bottle, sprinkle it on different things for different effects. Yes. Oh, that guy looks kind of new. Let's fuse kinstones with him real fast if we can. We can't. What about you? No, we can't. You? No, we can't. You? No, we can't. You? You suck. Old lady! Ah, rupees. That's another good thing. Usually when you fuse for rupees, this is where you find the golden monsters. This is... aww. Usually when you want to fuse for something, try and find someone who wants to fuse rupees, hearts, or a question mark, because that's usually the good stuff. And you had to do that so we can do this. Bada bing, bang a boom, and over here. all the way into this lady's house. Hopefully her cat wants to... Whoa, did you see that cat looking at me? I know it wants a piece of me. Yeah, watch this. It tries to swipe at you. Now guess what we have to do? Now it's not as simple as us just returning back to normal size. No, we can't do that, because nothing in the world of Legend of Zelda Minish Cap is that simple. No, now we have to go across, back across the way, go through this right here, not worry about these two. Oh wait, you want a few skin stones? I'll try. Can't fuse skin stones with you either, you suck. So I'll just, yeah, you wait there. I'll be back. Not really, but I'll be back. And you got a book of the library called the Harulian Bestiary. So guess what now, guys? Now, oh, if it wasn't bad enough, we have to go and take back the book to the guy at the book place. And basically, he sends us on more side quests to get more books for him because he's too lazy to go get them himself. You see where this is taking us? Hey, look at that, a long-lost copy of Harulian Bestiary. Link, are you returning this book? Thanks so much. I can't begin to describe how much I'm looking forward to putting this back. Cool. The next overdue book is, let's see, yes, of course, Legend of the Picori. It's been out forever. It was checked out by a somewhat absent-minded scholar, I believe. Oh, an absent-minded scholar. Basically, this guy they're telling you about now, they really mean absent-minded when they say absent-minded. Basically, what you have to do, go here, knock this out, down the ladder. Oh, getting a little ahead of myself right now. Basically, I think after I get these last two books, because I believe, yes, there are two books missing, that I'm going to call this episode quits, or call this episode finished, finito. Done for, done spar. If I'm correct, this is the guy's house. What, huh? A book from the library? Yes, of course, I knew this day would come. Please, come in. Thank you, sir. Hi, how are you? I'm a researcher of Picori Legend and Lore. My name is Dr. Left. Kind of looks like Dr. Right. You hear about that book Legend of Picori, aren't you? Well, I hate to say this, but I haven't seen it in several days. Perhaps a mischievous little mouse has taken it. Well, I'm sure it's in this house somewhere, and I just don't know where. But I'm very busy right now, so why don't you just look for it yourself? Basically, this guy's giving us permission to ransack his house. Sweet. I love when people give us permission to do this. Basically, guys, this guy's telling us to do is this. Oh well, you want a few skin stones? Maybe later. Basically, we get to do possibly one of the most annoying quests in this game, up and coming. You guys see this? See how we can't move this because we're too dang small? Yeah. Here it comes. We talk to this guy right here, this dude right here. Hey, do you know the clues that reveal the location of the treasure? Cross the bridge that spans the rapid flow through the land of the fearsome beast until you reach the misty falls. The treasure sleeps on the other side of the entrance. Yeah, so basically he just told us a legend that we have to follow. Problem being, we kind of can't leave this place right now. Or wait, or can we? We can, actually. The secret is, of course, what did I have to do earlier? Yep, if you guys guessed, get another empty bottle, put water in said empty bottle, put out dude's fire, because we're jerks like that. And yeah, you guessed right, because guess what? That opens up a new bridge area type place to us. Sorry if I put out your fire, broski. It has to be done in the name of Picori Legends. That will get us power. Yeah, it did say it's an object that allows little people to push big things. This is good. This is something we want very much. Basically, we go back into this guy's house, and what we do from here is, of course, do what we did before. Go up through the fireplace. Like Santa, but in reverse. Now, guess what? Talk to this guy. I really like this house. It's the best place in the whole human town. I'll be right back, guys. More like, I'll be back next time, guys. Jack of all trades, and I'll see you guys next time.